So we are going to start our problem with a circle, then we're going to pull a vertical chord, which we will label as AB, and we can say that the length of this chord is equal to 4. Now this chord will divide our circle into two segments, in which we will inscribe two circles just as shown in the sketch. Now the question is, can we somehow calculate this red shaded area? This problem was actually presented to me by one of my subscribers, Iago, not so long ago. He sent me an email with this original image, which I'm showing you right now. So I have decided to share it with you guys and make a video about it. So thank you, Iago, once again for this wonderful suggestion. And of course, if you guys like to try this problem for your own, you can pause the video right now, give it a try, and then come back and check the solutions. Alright, so let's solve this one. So, I will offer you three different methods to solve this particular problem. In first method, we're going to use the Pythagorean theorem to get to our solution. So first, I will pull the vertical diameter of our big circle. Then, I will label the vertices of this diameter as D and E. Next, I will label the center of our big outer circle as O, and the centers of two of our smaller inner circles as P and Q. And I will also label the point of contact between two inner circles, which is actually also a tangency point, as C. Now, as you can see from the sketch, the centers of all three circles are located on the vertical diameter of our big outer circle. And we can actually prove this by using the theorem of a two circle, which states that if two circles touch each other externally or internally, then their point of contact lies on the straight line joining their centers. As you can see, this is exactly the case with our two inner circles. Their radius will lie on a straight line. But since this theorem also applies to two circles that touch each other internally, you can see that the sketch on the right corresponds to the points of contact D and E between our outer and our two inner circles. So, in this way, we have a proof that the centers of all three circles are located on the diameter of our big outer circle. Furthermore, we know that the point C is dividing our chord AB into two identical segments, since the symmetry applies. This means that the line AC will have the length of 2. Now, let's label the both radii of our two inner circles as R1 and R2. And let's also label the radius of our big outer circle as capital R. Now we can see that the line PC also represents the radius of our left circle, so we can label it as R2, and the line QC will represent the radius of our small circle, so we will label it as R1. Next, we can notice that our diameter DE is equal to the sum of the segments DP, PC, CQ, and QE. Since the diameter is equal to 2 times the capital R, we can substitute this and all other values for our segments, and if we simplify this, we will get the following. Here we can do some more simplification, and get that the radius of our big circle is equal to the sum of the radii of our two inner circles. Now, we will rotate the radius of our outer circle up until the point A. In this way, we will form this really nice triangle OCA. Now, let's try to find the base of this triangle OC. We can do this by subtracting the line OE from the line CE. As you can see, the line OE represents the radius of our big outer circle, and CE represents the diameter of our small circle on the right. So we will substitute those values, and Since the radius is equal to the sum of those two radii, we will substitute this value as well. Now we will get that the base of our triangle OC is equal to the difference between the radii of our two inner circles. Now we can use those two equations in our favor. But first, let's remind ourselves about the tangent of a circle theorem, which states that if we have a tangent to a circle and we pull the radius to the point of tangency, this radius will always be perpendicular to our tangent. With this in mind, we can conclude that the angle at the point C of our triangle must be the right angle, since AB is actually a tangent line to both of our inner circles. Therefore, we know that the triangle OCA must be the right triangle, and we can use the Pythagorean theorem. We can say that hypotenuse OA squared must be equal to the leg OC squared plus the leg AC squared. Now we will substitute the values from our sketch, and we can substitute the values for capital R and the segment OC which we got earlier, and we will get the following equation. Now we can work through this by using the square of binomial on the both sides of the equation. And since we have R1 squared on the both sides of the equation, we can cancel them as well as R2 squared. And when we rearrange the terms, we will get that 4 times R1 R2 is equal to 4, which means that the product of the radii of our two inner circles must be equal to 1. Now, let's try to find our red shaded area. We can find this area by subtracting the area of our big outer circle and combine the area of our two inner circles. Now we can substitute this for the formula of the circle and we will get the following. Here we can substitute the value of capital R for the sum of those two inner radii and get the following equation. We can work through this by using the square of binomial and get loose of those brackets, and then simplify by canceling the same terms with the different signs. Finally, we will get that our red shaded area is equal to 2 pi times R1 times R2. But we already know that the product of R1 and R2 is equal to 1, so we will substitute this value in and finally get that the red shaded area must be equal to 2 pi squared units, and this is our solution. Alright, so now let me show you the second method in which we will completely avoid the Pythagorean theorem. First, we will start by pulling the diameter of our big circle, then we will label this diameter the same way as we did on our previous method, and we will label the centers of all of our three circles the same way as well. Next, we will label the point of tangency between two inner circles as C, just as we did in our previous method. Now, we already have a proof that C divides the chord AB into two identical segments, so we can say that AC and CB are both equal to 2. Now, let's label the radius of a small inner circle as R1 and the big inner circle as R2. This means that BC will also have the length of R2 and QC will have the length of R1. Now, from here, we will use the intersecting chord theorem, which states that if we have a circle and two intersecting chords, then the product of the lengths of the line segments on each chord are equal. As you can see, I have labeled the sketch on the right the same way as sketch on the left, so you can see exactly what's happening. Now, we will use this equation for our sketch on the left. We can just substitute the values of those segments and we will get the following. From here, we can simplify and finally get that the product of R2 and R1 is equal to 1. Now, let's find our red shaded area. We already know that this area is equal to the difference between the area of the big circle and the combined areas of two inner circles. And we have already shown in the first method that this is equal to 2 pi times R1 times R2. So I'm not going to do this all over again. So we can now just substitute the product of our two radii and we will get the following. From here, we can conclude that the red shaded area must be equal to 2 pi squared units, and this is, again, our solution. Finally, let me show you the third method, in which we will use some out-of-the-box thinking. For this method, we can notice that nobody actually gave us the radius of our big circle, neither the radii of two inner circles. So we can play around with those values. Let's say that the radii of two inner circles are actually equal. In this way, the chord AB will represent the diameter of our big circle, and this means that the radius of this circle must be equal to 2. This also implies that the radius of our smaller inner circle must be equal to the half of the radius of the big circle, so it is equal to 1. Now we can easily find the red shaded area, since it is equal to the area of the big circle minus area of two small inner circles. We can now substitute the formulas for the area of the circles and substitute the values of our radii to finally get that the red area is equal to 4 pi minus 2 pi, which means that our red shaded area is equal to 2 pi squared units, and again, we have our solution. Well, I really hope you guys enjoyed this interesting problem. And if you have a problem of your own that you want me to solve, you can always contact me by an email down in the description. Also, if you found another, different way to solve this problem, please write it down in the comment section. And if you enjoyed this video, please consider giving it a like or subscribe to the channel. Those stuff really means a lot when growing a channel. And of course, until next time, as always, see you all and take care.